Welcome back to TechTube.com. In this short lecture, we will understand how to find out candidate key from a given set of functional dependencies. This is most important part because all the rest of the things in database design chapter is dependent on how you find out candidate key and whether it is correct or not, because the next lecture, which is normalization, it depends on the candidate key. So everything is like quite dependent on this, and obviously you can always expect questions related to this also. So first of all, we will understand how to proceed to find out candidate key in correct manner. So this is set of functional dependencies given, right? What do we understand from it is, like A and C, D, C determines D, A determines C, D determines B, and E determines F. It means C, D, B, and F can be determined somehow, right? So what is the attribute which cannot be determined? So the attributes which cannot be determined is not present in right hand side, right? It means if the attribute cannot be determined, it should be present in the set of candidate key. I'll repeat myself, or you should make it you should note it down somewhere. The attribute which is not present in right hand side will be present in the candidate key. Okay, so first of all, we will write the attributes which are not present in right hand side. So which are the attributes? A, B is there, C is there, D is there, E is not there. Okay, so A is the attribute which is not present in right hand side. So AE will be there in the candidate key. Now we will see if some other attributes are also required to find to form set of candidate key. So the best way to check is find out closure of these attributes. So closure is, as we understand, closure is something that if we have to find out closure of an attribute, we check what are the attributes which can be determined from this set. Okay, so the attributes which can be determined are A, E. Then as A can determine C, so we can determine C. Now from C we can determine D, so we have D. Now from D, from this D we can determine B, so B is also there. And from this E we can determine F, so F is also there. Okay, so if you see in this case, in this particular example, we can determine all the attributes with the help of AE only, right? Like A, E, C, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, all the attributes we can determine. It means this is our candidate key. Okay, now you will have an example where you cannot determine only with the help of the attributes which are not present. Okay, so in that case you have to check for the all the possible combinations which we can take and which may act as a candidate key. So in next lecture, in next example, we will understand some different kind of examples where we have to take other combination apart from the attributes which are not present there in the right hand side. So now you can go and try solving the question based on finding out candidate key. So I hope you understand it. Thanks for watching.